Let's go ahead and go to Greg Reese's report, and we'll be back with the really big news. Stay with us.
Islam is an ideology based on the teachings of the Quran and the Hadith. While it is taught that the Quran is the literal word of God as taught by the Prophet Muhammad, we know that it was written after Muhammad died. It was assembled and officially released during the first three caliphates by a priest class of Islamic warlords. Curiously, several of the symbols chosen to represent Islam were prominent symbols in the Roman Catholic Church, such as the Babylonian symbol for Baal, the all-seeing eye, the seal of Melchizedek, and the Virgin Mother. A good Muslim is expected to accept the Quran and the Hadith as the word of God, and to emulate Muhammad as the perfect man. And as you study these books to learn how Muhammad lived his life, you will learn that the great prophet was a slave owner, a spousal abuser, a pedophile, and a polygamist. The Quran will teach you to fight and enslave all non-believers, and to never be friends with Jews or Christians. The Quran will teach you that going to war against Jews and Christians is virtuous, and that war is deceit. According to Islam, lying to non-believers is a virtue. Lying is such a virtue in Islam that there are four different varieties taught. Taqiyya, for example, is a lie to advance the cause of Islam by gaining the trust of non-believers. When Muhammad died, the Islamic priest class made it their priority to subjugate all Muslims, to murder, rape, and enslave the non-believers, and establish severe Islamic law in every land on earth. Over the next 1,400 years, millions of Christians and Jews were taken as slaves. Judeo-Christian societies were destroyed and replaced with Islam. When Rome finally retaliated, they ultimately failed to take back the Holy Lands. The Crusades were brief and mild compared to the Islamic caliphates. And yet, most Americans hear all about the Crusades, but nothing about the Islamic caliphates. We are often told there is no such thing as jihad. This should be alarming to anyone outside of Islam. The Islamic ideology of conquest has inspired other monsters in history. When the KKK was reformed in 1915, it was modeled after Islam, and their doctrine was named the Quran, which according to clan traditions means Quran. During World War II, the Nazi SS converted to Islam and aligned themselves with the Muslim Brotherhood. With much help from Barack Obama, the Muslim Brotherhood has infiltrated the Democratic Party in America. Ilhan Omar, Rashida Tlaib, and Keith Ellison identify themselves with Islam. They were sworn into Congress using the Quran, which means they can legally lie to the American people so long as it benefits Islam. They are openly aligned with organizations that support seeing Islamic law practiced in America. Challenging American freedom from within, these elected representatives attack Christians and Jews while scolding American citizens as racists and Islamophobes if we dare question their loyalties. Those who understand Islam can clearly see that jihad has come to America. In a 2011 poll, 24% of Muslims believe that military attacks against civilian non-believers is justified. Moderate Muslims claim the Quran is misunderstood and that inspiring jihad is not its purpose. But the difference between a religion that accidentally inspires mass murder and one that deliberately inspires mass murder is meaningless. Islam will never stop. And eventually, the need to defend our American way of life will outweigh the fear of being called racist. The question is, will it be too late? For NewsWars.com, this is Greg Reese.